How many times does our sin draw us in? We get free. We feel like we don't have any shackles on. We don't have anything hindering us. And the first thing we do is we get caught up in pleasure, in those things that we should not do, and those things that would hinder us in our walk. So he gets caught. What you don't see, and if you read about it a little bit further down, you realize that Abraham has to go and get him and set him free because they had captured him. And so he does, and then Abraham goes back to Canaan. And what does Lot do? He goes right back where he was. And this goes on for another chapter. And finally, God gets fed up with Sodom and Gomorrah. And decides to get rid of the city. So when the angels come, they tell him, arise, take your wife and 2 daughters who are here, lest you be consumed in the punishment of the city. So they do. They run away. We all know about it. Wife turns back around, turns into a pillar of salt. If you read a little bit before that, though, you would realize that he had sons-in-laws and other family that were in the city that didn't go with him. In other words, when he leaves the last time, he only pretty much has the clothes on his back, his wife, and 2 of his daughters. Have you ever heard the phrase that sin will take you farther than you want to go, keep you longer than you want to stay, and cost you more than you want to pay?
Amen.
This is exactly where we're at with Lot. He leaves Sodom and Gomorrah with only a remnant of what he started with. He started with so much that Abraham and him couldn't stay together, right? He starts out the story with success. He starts out with what we would say, you know, a good setup. Not only does he have everything he needs, he's in the best place that he could possibly be. And what happens? He gets closer and closer. Now, you can't tell me he didn't know what was going on. He knew the city was evil, but he's getting closer and close and closer until it destroys him. And you'll find even then, the rest of his life is messed up. Just messed up. But Lot's problems aren't unique to him. We all struggle with what we should do and what we shouldn't do. Y'all have ever heard Romans 7:15, Paul talks about it. He says, I don't understand what I'm doing. The things that I should do, I don't do. The things that I don't want to do, I do.
Amen.
And it's like that for all of us, right? So how do we get free? Because, like I said, with Lot, he was free. And he made a shipwreck. How many of us, we get free, or we think we're free, and we make a shipwreck? The fact is, true freedom isn't found in the absence of rules, but in a relationship with Christ. Without Christ, we're slaves to our flesh. See, all our flesh wants to do is what's easy. All our flesh wants to do is what's hot, what's pleasurable, what's fun. We, in our regular fallen nature, are going to do it if we are by ourselves. Now, granted, we might have a whole lot of willpower at first, but it's going to be on our mind.
Amen.
And it's only a step between being on our mind till it's in our mouth or our actions are doing it. So in John chapter 8, verse 31, Jesus said to the Jews who believed on him, if you abide in my word, you are my disciples indeed, and you shall know the truth, and the truth shall set you free. So by having a relationship with Christ, who is the truth, we know, we can get free. Now they said, hold on a second. We're grown men, okay? We ain't never been slaves to nobody. What are you talking about, we can be free? He answers and says, I say to you that whoever commits a sin is a slave to sin. The fact is, because of our daddy Adam, we're slaves to sin. It's fine. I don't need it. We're slaves to sin. We can't act right by ourselves. We can't do right by ourselves. We can't live right by ourselves. We can't talk right by ourselves. We can't do it. We just can't. Next one. But there's a way. Once we accept Christ, we no longer have to remain bound to our flesh. But we can walk forward depending on God and our fellows, because we're one body. So we can't do it by ourselves. Again, but we need the people sitting next to us. Turn to your neighbor and say, I need you if I'm going to be free.
I'm going to be free.
But mainly, we do this by turning, by standing, and by walking. Next slide. Turning, Acts 3:19. We have to turn to God and turn away from sin. So we have to do an about face and start moving in the opposite direction. By standing, Galatians 5:1. We have to stand fast in the liberty which is in Christ. Because we're His, we don't have to be bound by what we used to do.
Amen.
Like my brother said, old things have passed away. And behold, all things can become new if we wanted to. And finally, by walking in the Spirit, by being in the Word, by listening to what He has to say for us, we truly can be free. But again, it's not freedom from rules. It's freedom from our flesh, freedom from our sin nature, freedom from the shackles that would bind us. So the question is, are you free? That's all I have.